Are you tired of doing the same work over and over, sending reports, copying data, clicking through the same menus? It's repetitive, it's boring, and it takes time away from the work that actually matters. The truth is, the more you can automate, the more time you free up to focus on projects that really drive growth. In this video, I'm going to show you how to use Automa, a no-code automation platform, to eliminate that repetitive work. You can literally record your actions once and replay them forever, chat with AI and have it build workflows for you, or use the drag and drop builder for precise control. And the best part, it works with almost any app on your computer or online with no complex integrations and no coding required. By the end, you'll see how much of your day you can put on autopilot. So to get started, just click the link down below and you'll be taken to the Automa site. Right now, Automa is available for Windows with Mac and Linux coming very soon. So just click on Windows here and you will start downloading the file. And once it's downloaded, just run the installer and it'll install in a few seconds. After the installation, start up Automa and then go to sign up here to create a free account. And you can use your email and password or just sign in with Google or GitHub. And then once you've created your account, just sign in. And lastly, to complete the final step in installation, go to your profile here, go to tools and go to automation plugins. So Automa can control any application on your computer and it can also control any application in your browser. You just have to add this little extension to give it the permissions to do so. So it supports all major browsers here, Chrome, Edge, Firefox. So let's say we want to install it for Chrome. Just hit the installation button right there. And it'll install in a few seconds and then just go to enable. And then it's going to give you a little bit of instructions for what you need to do. But all you need to do is just go here to your Chrome extensions. You can just copy and paste this right into your Chrome browser. It's the easiest way to get where you need to go. And then make sure it's on enabled and make sure developer mode is on. That's it. And then just restart Chrome. And the steps for Edge and Firefox are pretty much the exact same. So just use your browser of choice. So within Automa, there are actually three different ways you can create your automations. And the first is just a recording function where you can literally record anything you do and Automa will play that back for you an infinite number of times. So you just never have to do the same tasks again. So just go to new and go to for PC. By the way, you can also automate tasks on Android. So let's say we want to create a morning routine where we open the same apps every single time. So that would be a really simple automation you can make with Automa and then just hit record and then record again. And now it's looking at everything you're doing and it's recording it. So then if you double click anything or any action you do, it's now recording. And so we see that we opened Evernote. Now, if we just play back that simple automation, we can see our mouse moving and it opened Evernote. So of course, you can open as many apps as you want and you can navigate within screens and even within your browser. And in fact, let me show you one I built where I want to share my YouTube analytics with somebody else. I'm going to export my YouTube analytics into a spreadsheet and then share that. And so you can see I've built this automation and let's say I want to do that today because of course analytics are always changing and you don't want to always share that report manually with your team. So I've already recorded that and let's see it run live. So it opened up Microsoft Edge. Now it's navigating to YouTube. It's opening up the YouTube studio. These are all the actions I independently took that it's playing back. Navigating to my analytics, going to advanced mode, then opening up a new Google Sheet. You can see the system's smart enough to wait till things load and open properly. So it's not just macros. It knows what's happening on screen. Now I want to share that. Let's say I want to share that with someone on my team. And it got to the stage this time and it errored out. Now, normally it works, but occasionally it does run into hiccups. And so that's why you can see that while the recording feature is really powerful and most times it works just fine, sometimes it does run into errors. And so it's a great place to start, but it's also one where you still do have to do some refinements. So your mileage might vary with this feature. This is a brand new feature and it's consistently getting better. So try it out and see if it works. And if you do run into an issue, then you might just have to troubleshoot that. So now that I've shown you the recording function, let me show you another way you can build automations easily. And this is by using the magic commands. And magic commands are a API powered chatbot that can build automations alongside you. So just create a new project like we did, and then just go to the corner here and drag in magic commands from the left bar. Then we are going to select a web automation. Then it's going to take you to your desktop so that you can start working with the apps that you need to work with. So you can just choose general here, and this is a web automation. Now we can just delete all of this. Now let's say we want to scrape data from some sort of dashboard that we check regularly. Let's say that's some internal dashboard that doesn't have an API that just exports into another format. So let's say you want to grab this data, transform it, and send it to someone else. And so to illustrate this concept really simply, I'm going to pick a simple data set like a crypto exchange where the data is always changing. And so we're just going to scrape the first 10 results. So you can just speak to it normally, scrape the first 10 results of this crypto table. And then what we're going to do is we're going to use the capture here. Then we're going to open up our browser. Then we're going to go to Edge here. And we are going to hold control and just start clicking on things. And then we're just going to hit expand selection until it captures all the data we want, which is this right here. And then we just hit that button right there and scrape the first 10 results of this crypto table. Then we can just send that command. And so then it says we can try running it. And so we can see that it succeeded and it grabbed all the data we see there. Next, we can add another command like save all of these results as a CSV file. Then we can just tell it that we want that command, and it's then gonna interpret what we're saying and figure out the exact steps it needs to take in Automa. Okay, it's saying it did it. And so make sure you choose a save location. So for simplicity, I'm just gonna save it to our desktop. We're gonna say example. Of course, name the file, and then we just hit test. And so if we check our desktop, boom, we can see that it grabbed all the information and entered it into a document. So now anytime we want to run that same operation, we can just open it and hit test. So that was the magic commands, and this feature is available in the pro plan, but you can get started for free with the recording and the drag and drop workflows I'm about to show you next. Of course, scraping data is just one of the use cases for this magic commands method. And there's so much more you can do, like automatically downloading Gmail attachments to cloud storage or summarizing Slack messages daily. Really, it comes down to what your individual use cases are and what work you need to automate. Because of course, everyone's work will be different. So far, I've shown you the recording function and the magic command function. And now I want to show you the drag and drop function, which is going to give you the most precision control. And this is the most advanced method. It does require you understanding how the app and even your operating system works, but it's still easy in the sense that you aren't coding anything. So in this example, I'm just going to open Evernote and make a new note. And so that's just a simple example. And you can, of course, do much more complex things. And so what we want to do is just drag in the task that we want the system to automate. So the first thing we want to start with is run open. So we want to open a specific software. In this case, we're choosing Evernote. So just click select and select Evernote. And then we are done. Next, we want to actually test this. So if you just hit run, it should just open Evernote. And you can see it opened Evernote. Great. And next, we want to hover our mouse over the button that we want to click. So drag in the hover mouse over element and then hit select. And then we're going to go capture element. And then we're going to wait until the red selection menu loads. And then we're going to hold control and click the button. And so it made a little preview for us there, and we can hit done. Next, what we want to do is we actually want to click that element. So we just want to click that. We just drag in click because the mouse is already going to be there. And then finally, we want to actually type something. Hey, everyone. And then we just hit done. So now let's test this automation. Close Evernote first, of course, and let's run it. So it should open Evernote, create a new note, and type, hey, everyone. Click that. And it typed, hey, everyone. And we're done. Now, of course, that was a very simple example I gave you, and you can imagine that you could make multi-app workflows and anything you like, really, by just dragging in the appropriate items from the left-hand menu. And this way, you make sure that the automation works perfectly because you're testing every step. Because with the recording function and with the chatbot, they are easier to use, but they might not get everything right perfectly. And so with this, you get to test every single step to make sure that it works. So sometimes there might be something that's not working optimally, and you do need to do some troubleshooting steps and some customizations in order to make sure that it is running the way that you want it to. But that time spent figuring out how to get the automation to work perfectly is worth it, because then you will not have to do that task over and over again. So try the recording function and try the chatbot function if your automation is a little bit more straightforward. But if you need something a little bit more involved and you need perfect precision, then the drag and drop builder is probably the best way to go. So that's three easy ways to put your repetitive work on autopilot. Whether it's recording your actions and replaying them, asking AI to build the workflow alongside you, or fine-tuning things with the drag and drop builder. The point is, you don't have to waste your time on busy work anymore. Automation doesn't just save you time, it makes your work more consistent, more accurate, and frees you up to focus on the projects that actually drive growth. And while Automa is simple enough for anyone to get started with, it's also powerful enough for enterprises, teams uses to streamline customer service, finance, HR, and more. If you're ready to try this yourself, I'll leave a link below so you can sign up for Automa for free in less than a minute. And if you found this video helpful, make sure you like this video and subscribe for more ways to save time and grow your business. In fact, if you want another automation tutorial, check out one of these two videos right here that YouTube recommended for you. I'll see you in the video.